Good afternoon, everyone. I'm just actually going to wait about a minute or two, just as people start filtering onto the webinar. We're also streaming on Facebook Live as well. So I just want to give everyone a little bit of time just to settle in before we actually get started. So I'll probably start at around 12:02. So for those of you who are logging on right now, we haven't started the webinar yet. We're just waiting a couple of minutes just for everyone to settle in. As people are logging on, just let me know if you're having any audio or visual problems with Zoom or whether you're on Facebook Live. I will be monitoring the webinar today. So if there's any technical difficulties, just let me know in the chat and I'll be more than happy to help anyone out there. So I'll just give it a little bit more time and then I'll get started here. I think that chat is enabled for everyone. Okay, so I'm going to get started. My name is Sandra. As I said just a few seconds ago, I will be monitoring the webinar today. So if you have any technical difficulties, feel free to reach out to me in the chat. I enabled the chat, so I think it should be good to go for anyone who needs it. And I also be monitoring the Q&A at the end of the webinar. So if you have any questions, please feel free to post them into the chat, and then our speaker today will be able to answer them at the end of the webinar. Our speaker is Marc Belaiche. He is the president and founder of Guhuza.com, and he will be discussing Guhuza's live interview technology, and he'll be going through a couple of video demos that he has with us today. So I think that's it on my end. I'll pass it over to you, Marc. I hope everyone enjoys the webinar. And again, just if you have any questions, post them into the chat. And I'll also have some contact information that I will post into the chat as well. So even after the webinar, if people want to reach out to Marc, you're more than welcome to do that. So thank you, everyone, and I'll see you back at the end.
Well, thanks very much, Sandra. And I really appreciate all the work that you do to get these organized and set everything up. So welcome to all of you who are watching. In this webinar, I'm going to show you how this demo or how this platform is very different from anything that you've seen before. You have to really open your mind if you haven't seen anything. If you haven't been exposed to Guhuza as yet, you're probably, okay, well, how is this different? And I'm going to walk you through all that because it's very different from anything that you've seen if you're in the process of recruiting. So I'm going to walk you through the platform. I'm going to show you how you can use it most effectively, how you can interview live online with candidates in a matter of minutes, which is our goal for to you. And also cover any questions that you might have, as Sandra mentioned. So feel free to put them in the chat and we'll cover them through as we get closer to the end. So first off, I just wanted to talk you know, a little bit about the recruiting space, where we're at right now and what's been happening. And you don't have to go very far to hear in the news or read online or whatever, social media, about how difficult it is to find staff and how challenging it is. It's been a really interesting time period. I mean, you know, none of us have gone through the various situations with COVID and the pandemic and how it has changed recruitment and jobs and how people work. But one of the things that we did as a group was after the pandemic hit was that we realized that there were a lot of changes going on. People obviously working remotely, hybrid situation, how people connect with each other, how they want to be connected with, how they're, you know, many people are at home. I think at the peak of the pandemic in in May of 2020, 40% of Canada's population was working from home. Right now, depending on which study you read, it is about 20 to 25% of people working from home. You've got retired boomers, a lot of them retired through this whole process. Hiring is challenging. There's over a million jobs open in Canada, according to Statistics Canada, and you just don't have enough workers. And you also have immigration is down, notwithstanding that they say that it's opening up the borders and everything else. It is slow. People aren't coming in as quickly. So you factor all those situations, all those factors into the mix, and you're left with, you're in a situation where you're trying to hire people and you're trying to interview and you're not getting the same number of applications that you once did. And it's a challenge. So so after the pandemic, we sat down as a group, and we have about 150 years of recruitment experience in our group. And we said, you know, how can we improve things? So we took a step back and we said, look, what are the problems, first off? So on the problem for employers, well, there's many. One problem, and we have heard this many, many times, one problem is that it takes a long time to find somebody. It takes on average 36 days to fill a position. The second part of it is that you have to go through a bunch of resumes. And if you get a fairly open, general type of a role, you might get 50, 100 more resumes. Maybe you might not get that many. So you have to go through them. Then you have to schedule interviews. And then the worst of the worst is that you do all that work, you line up a few good candidates, and half of them ghost you, or all of them ghost you, or maybe you only had one great candidate that you were relying on, and they don't show up for the interview. So these are all very real scenarios that are happening every day. In fact, they're probably happening right now as we speak. So those are the problem with the employers. The problems that employers have. On the job seeker side, the current processes are very, very frustrating. What happens is, for job seekers, is they might go to a job board, they might post their resume, they might search some jobs, they might find some jobs that they like, they get excited after reading a whole bunch of long job descriptions, long and lengthy job descriptions that you've written, and they get excited and they apply and they tweak their resume. Well, before they apply, they tweak their resume, they tweak their cover letter, they get excited, they push that submit button. Well, guess what? 75%, 80, 85, 90% of those people never hear anything back at all after all the time that they've spent. So job seekers have a lot of frustrations with current processes as well. So when our team sat down, we said, you know what, how do we fix all these problems? Is there a way to fix everything? And this is what we're going to show you, because Guhuza.com fixes all those problems in each of their unique ways. So I'm going to share my screen here and walk you through how all that stuff works. So it's going to take a second for my screen to load. And here we are. So first off, this is our website, Guhuza.com. We wanted to make it very simple for job seekers. So remember I told you just now that job seekers find the whole process frustrating. Well, we just said, you know what, all we want you to do is create your profile, upload your documents, and then you're going to be messaged when there's a job that interviews live. So you don't see, hey, apply. You don't see searching for resume or searching for jobs. You don't see applying for jobs. You don't see any of that on here. All they have to do is effectively upload their resume, and that's it. And you'll be like, well, wait a sec, how do they find out? I'm going to walk you through how they find out about job opportunities. But that's all we ask them to do. We ask them a few other questions about their compensation and location, all that, if we don't get the right information from the website, from their resume. So as I go back to the main page, I'm now going to walk you through the employer side. So again, very simple for the job seeker. We said, we don't want you to apply. You won't see any jobs on here. You won't see any positions that are posted. There's no job board that they actually go onto. Again, not again, but like we show here, Guhuza is not a job board. So you have to change your mindset about what a job board is and what Guhuza is. So I'm an employer. So I click on here, I can create an account on here too. I'm logged in right now, but if you weren't logged in, you can create an account. I'm not going to go through that for purposes of this demo. It's fairly straightforward. We just ask you information about your organization, what you do, and so on. Very quick, you can register within 2 minutes or less in terms of creating an employer registration. So on the employer side, visually, here's what's going to happen. You're going to upload your position to our site. You're going to let Guhuza do all the manual work that you've been doing, searching through resumes, scheduling interviews, everything else. And you're just going to interview candidates within minutes on our platform. And then you're going to be able to offer or hire the role or bring them back in for a second interview. You can do a test as well if you'd like, and I'm going to show you how that works as well. But basically, we eliminate 90% of the time and errors in the hiring process in doing this. So you're probably saying, well, Marc, how do you, exactly are you doing this? Well, let me show you how this works. So I'm going to go into my account. And the main area here is my jobs and interviews. And you're going to click on this, and you can see all my jobs here. There's a number of different jobs that I have listed. And you're going to add a new job. Now, you're saying, well, this is just the same as I would otherwise. Yes, and it is correct. We do need a job description for something to happen here. So let's say I'm going to just put in accountant. I can upload my job description, very straightforward, click and drag it in this area. Or I can compose my job description. I can have copy and paste it in here. I can type it, free type, whatever I want. And then I can create my job post. So I'm not going to go through all this process through here, because you're probably very familiar with the posting process and everything else. So, okay, so now I'm going to go, here are my various jobs in here. I've got a number of different roles that I'm going to look through, but I'm going to go into this one, find candidates for this administrative assistant. Now, when I come to this page, I have my job here. I can edit my job at any point in time, but I'm using this job description. Now, what I've got here is I've got find candidates, and I'm going to just move this over here, and I'm going to move this over here because the Zoom video or Zoom bar is blocking my site here. So, okay, so at this point, I am in this role, administrative assistant, and I'm going to click this magic button called find candidates, and what happens here is Guhuza starts going through the process and finding candidates for positions that match, or for candidates that match your job description. Okay, so that's what happens at this point. So I'm gonna now go through what the candidate sees. Now what the candidate sees is, as soon as you push that button for matching candidates, they're gonna get an email, push notification to their app, and or a text message that basically says, here's a position that matches what you're looking for. So this is what they might get. You're going to get something that looks along the lines of this: join the waiting room and interview live right now. And they can read through the job description. They can then click through interview live right now. And once they do, they can see the job description again. They can review the job description to see if it looks like something that they'd be interested in. And this is happening within minutes of you pushing this button. So they can check the job description, see if it's something that they like. And if it's something that they like, they're gonna push this join waiting room button to interview live. Now this just now is referring a friend. So if they're not interested, they can also refer a friend. But coming back here, they're gonna join the waiting room. And then now they're in the waiting room for the executive assistant role. They can review the job description once again. And once the employer is ready to start the interview, they will accept the call on their phone, and then they can start interviewing live. They'll check, allow their camera and so on, and then they can interview live right there. So I'm gonna just run through that one more time, but this time for a text message. So they receive a text message instead. It's going to be the same process, but you may be, okay, well, what about the text message? So how the text message works is they get, Guhuza found a great position match just for you, in this case, customer service specialist. They're interviewing live right now. So they would push that button to have a look at what that job is. So at this point, they can scroll up and down. I know it might be small letters here, but they can basically look at the job description, see if they like it or not. And then if they do, they can again join the waiting room to come into the process. And I want to show you both sides of it, because there's both sides of this equation to fix both sides. Remember, we're trying to fix all the problems that job seekers have about applying to jobs and never hearing back. So now this person's in the waiting room for the customer service specialist. And then when the interview starts by the employer, they will accept the call on their phone, join the interview, and then be interviewing live right on the platform. And so I know it may be confusing. That's why I went through it both times, both ways, in terms of the candidate receiving a email and the candidate receiving a text notification. And they would get the same, they would go through the same process if they're doing it through a through our app as well. So that's kind of the process on that side of it. Now on the client side, on your side, remember, rewinding a bit. On your side, as the employer, all you've done is you've clicked the Find Candidates button. All this stuff is magically going on behind the scenes through Guhuza, our matching technology, our AI. We're finding the best candidates for you. They end up showing up here. They end up showing here, and then you can start the interviews from there. So I'm now going to show you how an employer would start the interview. I'm just going to back it up just slightly. So I click Find Candidates. Shadia has joined the waiting room. So she shows up on the right-hand side of the screen. You click on her name, you can see her profile. And then you can start interview. Now you can also click on the resume to see what Shadia's resume looks like. And there you go, you can review it either before or during the interview. But the point being is that we want to get candidates to you very quickly. So in this case, we're going to start the interview. And this is Diane here, who's going to start the interview with Shadia. And there's Diane. This is you doing the interview. And now Shadia is going to join into the interview as well. And here she is. So now Diane is the employer, and she's interviewing Shadia here. So fairly straightforward. We try to make it as simple as possible for you in order to get candidates. We want to get candidates to you quickly. Our goal is to have 3 to 5 candidates over to you to interview. And you can interview those people within literally minutes. Now, sometimes it might take a little bit longer, depending on the role, depending on who's available, depending on the time of day that you run the search and click Find Candidates. You might find that there might be a different batch of candidates that respond at 12 o'clock on one day versus at 7 o'clock p.m. another day. We also suggest that you only run these searches between 8 a.m. and 8 p.m. local time, Monday to Friday, because that's the time when we find that most people are responding to jobs and job descriptions. Now, we do also give you some other tips here before you start. When you're ready to start interviewing, you may want to read through those. But basically, when you're done, we just say, hey, click stop to stop the search, so our system knows that, you know, you're not looking for more people. Now, what happens is you will be also notified, so you don't have to be sitting here going, okay, well, is somebody coming in, somebody not coming in? You can also be notified yourself when a candidate comes into your waiting room. We call this the waiting room. And you do that by going into notifications and letting our system know when you want to be notified by SMS or email, ideally SMS. You want to put your cell phone number in there, so you get a notification that somebody has joined the waiting room. I realize there's a lot of new stuff here, and there's a lot of new information, and that's why I'm happy to answer any questions that you might have, because as you're looking through it, you might be, well, how does this work, or what about that? We get a lot of questions about how it works, but if you think of, if you're old enough to remember the transition from taxis to Uber, you're probably confused, how does this happen? And I go into somebody's personal car, and how does that work, and what it happens if? Well, this is the same. We took the best concepts of Uber, dating sites, and Netflix, and put them into Guhuza to make it a little bit more informative, faster. Again, we want to fix those problems. We want to focus on those problems, the 36 days. On our platform, we want to get it down from 36 days to 1 day. We want to get you hot, somebody in your company within 1 day. We want to fix how slow it is. We want to fix ghosting. You'll never get ghosted on our platform. And for job seekers, as I mentioned, we want to fix the problems that exist with them too, including having to go through long job descriptions, lengthy job descriptions, applying, never hearing back. And in fact, 80 to 90% of job seekers in our polls also mentioned that they got ghosted as well. So don't think it's just job seekers ghosting employers, it's employers ghosting job seekers as well. So we want to fix all those, and Guhuza does fix all those. So I'm gonna go back into, again, if you have any questions, throw them into the chat or the Q&A, and we'll go through them later on. So I'm just gonna go through and show you a few more features about the platform, probably another 10 minutes or so. 10-15 minutes, and then we'll go through some questions here as well. Now, by the way, if you ever want to book a one-on-one demo, you wanted some time, just click on here. You've created your account, just click on here. You can also access the book a demo just by clicking on an employer. There's lots of buttons here about see how it works. So I'm just going to go back here to my account. I'm going to next cover shortly skills tests and background screening that we have on the platform. I'm going to cover off the plans and pricing. Your company profile, you want to keep that up to date. Your personal information, payment options, your credit card, notifications I talked about, logins and security, fairly straightforward, billing history, and more. So I'm going to come back to some of these areas. But next, I want to cover off skills testing and background screenings. So on the platform, we have over 500 job-based and subject-based tests. So you can, if you have, say, a React developer test, you can do that on here. Typing tests, you can order them all on here. So for example, I'm gonna do a typing test, I'm gonna order it, I can put in the information who I wanna do the background test with, and what happened, and pay, and then what will happen is the candidate job seeker will receive a link to do that test. And once they do, you'll get an email back saying that the test has been completed, and it will show up in your candidate test results here as well. So I'm just gonna show you one very simple test. I'm just gonna do a typing test. I'm gonna view the report here. And this is what you'll see in your profile. This is just one example of the 500 tests that we have. So there's this one was a typing test, general test, intermediate. It'll tell you how long or how long it took, and also how difficult it is. And then you can also see like what the test actually was. So this was the original text that the person had to type, and then it'll tell you what the either mistakes were or spaces or whatever, so you can see how the person did. Now that's the same for any test that you do. So if you do a test that is, I don't know, whatever, there's so many tests on here. You can choose lots of different kinds on here that might be of interest, desktop publishing software, Adobe, and so on. They're all $49.99 for a test, and they're all, again, very easy to administer. We wanted to keep it very simple for everybody. So desktop, human resources, et cetera, et cetera. There's lots of categories. Now you might also be saying, well, what about background checks? Well, we do that as well. In the background checks area, we can do a Canadian criminal record check. We can do credential verifications, criminal checks in Quebec, driver's abstract, education verification. We'll make sure that the person has the degree that they say they do, an employment digital reference check. Everything is all done all through the platform. Okay. I always like this soft check because this soft check looks for anything publicly available for a candidate. It's only $19.99. And for a quick reference as to who the person is, it's always good to do a quick check for $20. It's pretty good money for, pretty good value for money for if you're inquiring about somebody in particular. So I'm going to come back to my account here and just cover off the rest of the tabs. Again, this is your main hub page. So we talked about your jobs, which is really the core part of Guhuza. Everything else feeds off of that. You can do a skill test or background screening, even if you haven't met the candidate through Guhuza. If you have somebody that you want to do a test on, you can do that through there. And I'm going to talk about plans and pricing right now. So the different plans that we have a different kind of model. We don't charge on the number of jobs that you upload. You can upload as many jobs as you want. We actually charge based on minutes that you interview candidates on the platform. One of the issues that we heard many, many times from employers was that they post on a job board and they don't get any candidates, or they post and they get too many and then they don't actually interview anybody. So we make our plans based on you actually interviewing candidates. We charge based on results. And on top of that, we give you 30 free interview minutes that you can use, and we top it up on a monthly basis. Now, there's no recordings in this one. There's no credit card required, and it's free to use. So it's no risk for you to use it, to try it, to push the button, find candidates, and to start interviewing. Now, if you have one open position, this will work. If you have 1 to 2 open positions, now this is for companies that might have, usually 1 to 10 employees, you have 1 to 2 open positions per month. It's only $29 per month, and we give you 3 hours of interview minutes to use. And you get recordings that'll stay in your account as well. And then from there, companies that are generally 11 to 50 employees is the business account, suitable for 2 to 5 open positions, $49 a month. It's 540 interview minutes. We don't want you to worry about, hey, I'm good at, I'm out of data or I'm out of time. It's like your cell phone or whatever. This should be enough hours for you to use for this many positions. And then for 6 to 10 open positions, which we tend to find 51 to 100 employees, you have 6 to 10 open positions on average in a month, you've got 40 hours of interview time, so a full week of interviews. And if you need more minutes, you can also buy them for $19 or $25 for 30 or 60 minutes. And if you need more minutes, or if you have more than 10 open positions, probably best to talk to us. We can create any kind of package that you want. Now, one thing I didn't show you here, and I'll just going to revert back to the recordings, is you go back to this job here, and I'm going to go to Shadia's profile, and I'm going to see the history. So in the history, I can see when I actually interviewed Shadia. So this one was not recorded, and I can see how long I did the interview for, and I can also see if I have the recording program, or if I have an account that includes the recording, I can also keep a copy of the recording as well. So there's myself and there's Shadia in this case. So lots of cool features. You can also order services directly on this candidate. So in the case of Shadia, I can do a background check and boom, check out. And Shadia's information is already pre-populated in here. I just wanted to revert back. And also, again, see my job, what it was. I can see her profile, and I can see her resume here as well. So you've got lots of different ways of finding information, and we've tried to keep it very, very simple. So this is the area. So I've gone through the pricing. I'm almost to the end of this portion of it. There's also help. If you need help, we have a great knowledge base that we put together. You can also access it through here too. How to use Guhuza, how to create your profile. If you need anything in particular, you can also contact us if you need to. You can text us at any time. We have inquiries line, sales line, tech support line as well. And there's a little bit about us as well, how we came to be, why we created the platform, and where we're at right now. Now you may ask yourself, and maybe this will be one of the questions that come through the chat, and that is, what does Guhuza mean? Where does that name come from? Is this just a bunch of random letters that have been formed together? And so I'll just answer that question, and then we'll turn to the live questions that have come in through the chat. But the name itself, Guhuza, it actually means to connect in Rwandan, which is in Africa. Rwanda is in Africa. We wanted something a little bit ambiguous. We wanted the fundamental word connect in the name because we felt that it was something that was going to be a little bit more memorable. We've had a lot of people pronounce it in funny ways, which is great because then you tend to remember it a little bit better. And we didn't want to have something like jobs or hiring or resumes or anything like that in the name because we're not a job board. This is under the umbrella of staffing platform. Staffing platform is a new element, a new way of people connecting with each other. So yeah, keep that in mind. Again, Toronto Guhuza is not a job board. If you think after this that it's just another job board, it's not. I haven't done a good enough job in explaining how it's different. There's no jobs listed on here. There's no way for job seekers to search anything. All they do is they upload their resume, and then we contact them when there's a good match of candidates. We don't blast the whole database. We only match with our matching technology and AI. We match and only send messages to candidates that have the skills that are required for the job based on your job description that you uploaded and the resume that they uploaded. And that's it. So I'll turn it back over to Sandra here, and maybe we can cover some questions from the attendees here. And I'm going to stop sharing this, and I might probably have to go back and forth to show different features. But welcome back, Sandra.
Yeah, we do have a good number of questions here. So the first question that we have is, is there any way to schedule interviews?
So we have got this a lot of times, and we know that the problem with the current situation is that people are getting ghosted. And so we didn't want that kind of scenario. We didn't want to go back to like a situation where people get scheduled interviews and then they don't show up. That was the whole point of Guhuza, was to connect people up faster. Now, I can't say that we haven't heard this question come up several times, and I can't say that we don't have this in our possible 2.0 rollout. But as of now, currently, it's the here and now. And if you think of Uber, when you request an Uber to take you from point A to point B, they don't show you vehicles that are in the lot or in the parking or in the garage or in for repairs, or the Uber driver is not looking to work. They only show you ones that are ready to go right now. So like I said, we have that on our 2.0 project list. We have about 350 projects on our list, to be honest with you. But it is the here and now. We built this as the here and now, and that's what job seekers want as well, is the here and now.
Okay, the next question. Yep. And the next question is, does the platform allow for more than one interviewee at a time?
That's a great question. So that is also on our 2.0 rollout, which will probably be next year. We do feel that that is something that would definitely be helpful for sure. What our plan is to do is to allow one interviewee or interviewer to invite somebody else to join with a link, whether it be by text or email or both, perhaps, or even through a push notification through the app.
The other question we have is, what was the feature where it said to buy minutes to interview candidates? So I think they're talking about the minutes section there.
Okay, well, I'll reshare my screen here. I'm not sure if this was here, but basically you go plans and services, live interviews, and you click buy now. And this is where you can get the different plans, different approaches. I'm not sure if this is answering the question or not, but this is where you're actually buying interview minutes. You're getting interview minutes for the platform for you to use the platform. And again, we give you 30 minutes interview free, like just because we want you to use it. And then as you use it more and you interview more candidates, then you can upgrade to higher level plans as you see fit. I hope that answers the question.
The other question we have, is there a percentage of what type of skilled workers you have resumes for on this portal?
Right. So generally our stats are that we get about 10% in each different area. So for example, we say there's 10% of job seekers that are in marketing, 10% in administrative, 10% in HR, 10% in skilled workers. So we don't exclusively focus on one area, but about 10% are in any one of those general categories that we have.
And then if you can clarify if whether or not the platform is just cell phone based or not.
Yeah, so if a candidate uploads their resume and they didn't put in a cell phone or they don't have a cell phone, we will be emailing them. No, it's not just purely cell phone. They can interview on their cell phone. Our vision is to have people, and I've interviewed many people that when they were in grocery stores or at parks or whatever it is, the point is that they can interview anywhere. So generally, if they have a cell phone, most people have some kind of cell phone, then they can interview right on the platform. We've been doing a lot of testing on the platform over the last year. We've interviewed people that are in buses, walking in parks, at fairs. We have if you check out our YouTube channel for Guhuza, you'll see various videos where we say, imagine if you're dot, 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 you're walking the dog, you're at a park, you're at a fair, you're at a concert, whatever it is, and you get a message on your phone and there's an interview that can happen live right on the platform right there. Wouldn't that be great? And just tell people to upload their resume. So yeah, so it is very much cell phone based, but we also email. Remember that if the person wanted a notification by email, just like the employer, the job seeker can also select to get notified by email as well, either push notification to their app, email to their regular email, or a text message to their phone. Because they can do any of those things, it's not just cell phone based, it can be email as well.
Okay, we have a couple more questions here. What is your matching AI technology based on?
So it's really, again, just based on purely the job description with the resume. We take the two of them. Look, I've been in the recruiting industry for over 25 years. And I can't say, hey, I've never missed a good candidate. And I can tell you I've also interviewed a candidate that didn't match the role. So it's not going to be perfect, but it goes, the technology overrides the human eye going through all these resumes and scheduling them. So we use a combination of different aspects, everything from the person's experience, where they worked. If you're thinking, well, what about where they live and the address and all that kind of stuff? We don't do that. We're matching based on we're matching based on the resume to the job description and vice versa. And I also want to add one more thing, and that is that what we have found also was that currently, if you're in the Toronto area, which is where I am, where we are based from, before COVID, you used to try to get somebody who was closer to the office, try to get them within 15 minutes, 20 minutes, half an hour of the office, because you didn't want them to have a long commute. But now, after COVID and remote work being what it is, we have found that employers sometimes start with that, you know, hey, I want to have somebody within a certain distance of where I am. But now with remote work, especially for those obviously positions that can be handled remotely, what happens is that the employers have been stretching a lot in terms of location. So, you know, I mean, even as a company for us, we have people in southwestern Ontario, we have eastern Ontario, north as well. You can have people from really anywhere. So hopefully that helps.
Oh, okay, that was just a thank you. Yeah, so we actually do have one more question. If you can talk about the relationship between Guhuza and TorontoJobs.ca.
Yeah, that's a great question. So TorontoJobs.ca powers Guhuza in terms of candidates. We have integrations that happen between the candidates and the candidates that have posted their resumes on TorontoJobs.ca and Guhuza. So there's that integration as number one. Number two is, we rely on testing from the TorontoJobs.ca team to help us give us feedback at Guhuza about who the you know, what the, is the matching working properly. So it's the visual that we're doing in addition to the machine learning that we're doing to figure out if we're delivering the best candidates for an employee, for an employer, I should say. So. So those are the main areas. There's a lot more integration between the two organizations, but they are two separate companies in the whole scheme of things.
Okay. Is there anything else you want to add before we close out the webinar?
Yeah. You know, look, I'm excited about what Guhuza does. It's really fixing a lot of the problems that exist for job seekers and employers. And if you see it now after having been on for 45 minutes. You will realize that, yeah, this is great. Like if you're an employer, why do you want to go through and post a job somewhere and get applications and schedule interviews and an interview and that whole process, again, takes 36 days when you can interview candidates literally within minutes here. Like, why would you choose option one, right? Like, why would you waste your time doing all that stuff and spending time, hours, instead of like just jumping to interview candidates as quickly as possible, especially in this market where, you know, over a million jobs are open in Canada and it's very, very competitive, and your competitors are using Guhuza to find candidates in minutes and you're spending time going through resumes. Like why would you punish yourself for that? And why would you pay to do that? Pay a platform like us to get you candidates in minutes and save yourself a lot of time. You know what I mean? It's a bit self-serving comment, I know, but at least you hopefully get the message across.
We do actually have another question coming in here just because we have a couple of minutes. Could you please describe more the general information available for the candidates you mentioned earlier? Where is that information sourced from? Could a job seeker ask you about the general information available for them? So I think earlier when you were talking a bit about candidates.
I'm not sure what general information it is.
Yeah, you can maybe be a little bit more specific. Let's see in the Q&A here.
I'm not sure. I do see the question here. I'm not sure exactly. Could a job seeker have the general information available for them? I'm not sure if that was to do with the testing or the background checks, or that was when they. I'm not really sure what that means. Sorry. I see the question here, and I'm sorry, I don't.
There is a package for $19.99 that can give. Oh.
Okay, I got it. Okay.
Thank you.
All right. So, yeah, thanks for the clarifying. So, I'll just go back to the screen here. So, what the question is, this has to do with the general information that goes on for background screening. So, if you want, I'm just going to empty the cart here. So, if you want, I believe this is the soft check. And SoftCheck is your lightweight one-stop service for finding anything by a publicly available record. So basically it searches all the databases and looks for anything in the public media, sex offender registries, court fraud, and so on, for any adverse media, risk of relevant information, criminal history, fraud, affiliations with negative groups, and so on. Public safety, and these are only for Canada as well. And these are typically completed within minutes as well. And and where is the information coming from? So it's coming from a number of databases that are taking to get all the information. And is it available to candidates? Yeah, candidates can also order it themselves if they wanted to. They can actually just do it themselves. They'd have to create an employer account. So they have to actually go through and create the process as an employer. They'd have to register. I'm just going to log out. And oops. Okay, so sorry. Okay, so they'd have to create their own employer account, they'd have to register, and then order it on themselves. So they can find out themselves for $20 what is publicly available that we're finding on the internet as well. Hope that helps.
Yeah, she said thank you. So that helped her out a lot.
Great.
Okay, perfect. Yeah, she just had a final comment there. Okay. I think that's all for today. I just wanted to mention that in the chat, I did provide some links for everyone if they wanted to check out any of the social media. I have Marc, your LinkedIn on there, and other contact information. And I am recording the webinar, so this will be up on YouTube, and I will be sending it out after the webinar as well for everyone. So yeah, I hope everyone enjoyed the webinar today. Thanks for taking time out of your day. And thank you, Marc, for your presentation.
Thank you, Sandra. Thanks, everybody, for being on as well.
Thank you.
Great day.
Bye for now.